12 يوم اشوف جناح انا بالنسبه لي زول كارثه.
For a parent to go 12 days without seeing their child is a crisis. To not know if he's dead or alive.
For 12 days, Omar al-Hassan's son Asim has been held by Sudanese security incommunicado. Just a day prior to our meeting, Omar and his wife were finally allowed to visit him at a local police station. Asim, a student leader seen here at protests in the Sudanese capital in April, shortly before his arrest. He's accused of killing a police officer and faces the death penalty. His family denies the charges, saying he was just a protester.
We were scared for him. We warned him about the consequences and all the different outcomes. We used to tell him, be careful, don't go, don't protest. But of course, in the end, with young people, you can't control them.
The process began last month over the government's proposed sale of Khartoum University's historic central campus. It has now become about much, much more. In the face of a government-enforced local media blackout, the students have been documenting the still unfolding process and the government's response. One student activist recently detained by Sudanese security forces agreed to speak to us. We agreed to conceal his identity for his safety.
We came out chanting, peaceful, peaceful. As our chanting grew louder, they gave the orders and released tear gas to separate the crowd.
He took these pictures in the early morning hours after his release. On his back, he says, you can see the marks left by the electricity wires that were used to whip him.
They throw you against the wall and keep your face against it. Take off your t-shirt and cover your eyes so that you can't see anything. They hit and hit and hit. And with it come the questions. Questions where it doesn't matter whether or not you're giving them the right answers. Blows and blows and blows and blows.
CNN has reached out to the Sudanese government for comment, but has not received a response. The government has previously linked these protests to opposition groups, accusing them of stirring unrest, but there's no word of any charges against any opposition figures. To date, a number of students have been killed, and several former and current students are being held by the authorities. Incommunicado, their families say. Their families and friends provided CNN with these pictures. They hope that they, like Asim Omar's parents, will finally get to at least see their loved ones. Asim's case has become something of a rallying cry, attracting a number of prominent Sudanese lawyers to his defense team, though the lawyers have yet to meet him. As lawyers and loved ones push for his release, the unrest continues. So too does the uncertainty over the fate of the other detained and missing students. Nima Elbagir, CNN, Khartoum, Sudan.